Hello and welcome. Today, I will show you how to install the new SMA Data Manager M. This tech tip is the first in a series of videos about our new products based on SMA's NXOS platform. You can find an overview of the videos here. Let's start by unpacking the SMA Data Manager M. The letters EDMM on the packaging stands for NXOS Data Manager M. The device's serial number appears again underneath the barcode in plain text. Now let's open the packaging and take out the quick reference guide first of all. The quick reference guide contains a section written in several languages and an illustrated section. The illustrated section of the instructions can be found at the end of the document. Now let's take out the labels next. Put these to one side. We'll need these again later. The device's serial number can also be found here. In addition to the actual device, the packaging also contains a bag of accessories, 2 6-in-1 two-pole plugs, and screws and screw anchors for the wall mounting. And finally, the Data Manager M itself. You can easily mount the Data Manager on a DIN rail, or alternatively, use the mounting brackets on the wall. This is the plug for detail inputs for active power limitation, and this is the plug for future supported Modbus devices with RS-485 communication. The Data Manager is delivered without a power supply unit, which means that you have to obtain one that complies with the specifications. For example, you can use the power supply unit for a cluster controller, an inverter manager, or the SMA web box. Now, let's look at how we actually install the device. We want to install the Data Manager and power supply unit on a DIN rail in a switch cabinet. For the purposes of this demonstration, we have already installed the power supply unit. We can simply click the Data Manager onto the DIN rail here. We then connect the power supply unit with the two-pole plug. And finally, we connect the Data Manager to the network. And that's it. Now let's look at the labels again. These labels contain some important information. PIC and RID to register the Data Manager in Sunny Portal. The WLAN network key and the QR code, which contains this information. I'm going to stick one of the two labels directly inside the switch cabinet so that this information can be referred to later. And I'm going to use the other label for the system documentation. Thanks for watching. More videos for examples about commissioning will follow soon.